the scientific revolution looms large as the real origin of both the modern world and modern mentality. This revolution outshines everything since the rise of Christianity and reduces the Renaissance and Reformation to the rank of mere episodes, said the noted historian Herbert Butterfield. The scientific revolution was a period when new ideas in astronomy, anatomy, and other sciences led to a rejection of doctrines that had prevailed since antiquity through the Middle Ages. It laid the foundation of modern science. Historians believe that the period of scientific revolution began with the publication of two works in 1543. On the Revolution of Heavenly Bodies by Nicholas Copernicus and Fabric of the Human Body by Andreas Vesalius. Vesalius's book is a compilation of the lectures given by him at the University of Padua, where he dissected corpses to illustrate his discourses. Fabrica revolutionized our understanding of our own bodies. It rejected Galen's worst errors that the great blood vessels originated from the liver.
Actually, not much. The medicines did not help
William Harvey was apprehensive of how the world would react to his new findings. He wrote, "Doctrine once sown strikes deep its root, and respect for antiquity influences all men. Still, the die is cast, and my trust is in my love of truth and the candor of cultivated minds." Copernicus's treatise refuted Ptolemy's hypothesis on the motion of celestial bodies in cycles and epicycles. His book was written in 6 volumes. In these 6 volumes, he argued that the observed back and forth motion of the planets in the sky could only be explained if we accepted the fact that both the Earth and the other planets moved around the Sun. Thus, Copernicus displaced the Earth from the center of the universe and presented to us a heliocentric universe. Interestingly, 3 decades before he published his treatise, Copernicus had distributed to a few friends an anonymous manuscript called Commentariolus, or Little Commentary. Being a clergyman himself, he had anticipated the wrath of the church. Perhaps in an attempt to ward off the wrath of the church, Copernicus eventually dedicated his treatise to Pope Paul III. The ideas propounded by Copernicus were taken forward in